Dear student, today we discuss another topic of our chapter, electrochemistry, and today's topic is determination of thermodynamic quantities delta G, delta H, and delta S. Delta G represent change in free energy, delta H represent change in enthalpy, delta S represent change in entropy and EMF of the cell. EMF mean it is a force which is responsible for flow of electron in a cell, and thus resulted into flow of current is known as electromotive force and represented as EMF. Now, to discuss this topic, we have to first discuss the relationship between electrical energy and Gibbs free energy. What is the electric energy and what is the free energy? We know that G is equal to H minus TS, and this G is known as free energy. It means that free energy is the difference between enthalpy and temperature entropy of the system. When then this enthalpy as well as temperature as well as entropy are the state function, it means that delta G is also the state function. Hence, it is depend upon initial and final value. It means that delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. This is the free energy. And what is the electric energy? Electric energy is equal to the electrical work done by the electrochemical cell. What is the electrochemical cell? A cell is said to be electrochemical when chemical form of energy is converted into electrical form of energy. The conversion of chemical form to electrical form is known as electrochemical cell. What is the electrical work? Electrical work is the product of electrical charge and EMF of the cell. What is the electrical charge? Suppose N is the number of electron passes through the external circuit of the circuit of electrochemical cell. Hence, its charge is equal to NF. And what is N? Is the number of mole. F is the charge, which represent in terms of Faraday, and Faraday is equal to 96500 coulomb. Hence, electrical work done is equal to NFE, where E is the EMF of the cell. Further, it is observed that the work or electrical work is equal to minus decrease in free energy or decrease in free energy. This topic I already explained in thermodynamics. In thermodynamics, in second chapter, we know that G is equal to H minus TS. So change in free energy is equal to delta G is equal to delta H minus TS. According to the first law of thermodynamics, dU is equal to dQ plus dW. When dW, work done by the system, it means that work done by the system, sign is negative. Further, it means that Q reversible is equal to delta U plus into W max. This is the entropy, and entropy is the heat absorbed or lost isothermally reversely divided by a temperature. So it means that its value is equal to Q reversible by T. And further, we know that delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta B. That is the basic definition of enthalpy. By putting these in this value, and the relation is observed that the work done is equal to minus change in free energy. Hence, it is observed that for a large number of reaction, the electric energy produced was not equal to chemical energy, and hence the Gibbs tells that electric energy produced is equal to the decrease in free energy of the cell reaction. It means that the electric work is equal to minus change in free energy. It means that minus delta G is equal to NFE, and it is the relationship between electrical energy and Gibbs free energy. This thing will be noted mainly for the determination of thermodynamic quantity delta G, delta H, and delta S, and EMF of a cell. Now we discuss our main topic, the determination of thermodynamic quantity delta G, delta H, and delta S, and EMF of the cell. EMF of the cell is used to calculate delta G, used to calculate delta H, and used to calculate delta H with respect to temperature. We know that the thermodynamic quantity functions such as delta G, delta H, and delta S can be calculated by the measurement of EMF of a reversible cell at different temperature. why the relationship between electric energy and Gibbs free energy, we know that delta G is equal to NFE. It means that delta G is equal to minus NFE. It is the formula which is used for the thermodynamic quantity delta G, that is change in free energy. And to determine the change in free energy, we have to note down this formula. It is used for the calculation of change in free energy. Further, we know that according to the Gibbs-Hamiltonian equation, delta G is equal to delta H plus T into d delta G by dt at P. It is the Gibbs-Hamiltonian equation. We already discussed in our previous topics, and it's very important topic. Now putting the value of equation 1 in equation 2 by replacing delta G in terms of minus NFE. So delta G is equal to minus NFE, delta H remain the constant and T remain the constant. Change in free energy, it will be changes in terms of minus NFE D into minus NFE by DT at constant pressure. Then the relation become NFE is bravo hai delta H in plus minus plus bracket start is equal to minus NFT into DEY DT, because N and F are the constant quantity in any cell reaction. It is observed. Then from this equation, we got a formula, that is delta H is equal to NF bracket start T into D delta G by DT at P minus E, and it is the required formula for the calculation of change in enthalpy for a cell reaction in which EMF is given. Then now we have to discuss the another one. What is the calculation of change in free energy? What is the calculation? How we can calculate the value of change in entropy? According to the Gibbs-Hamiltonian equation, we know that delta G is equal to delta H plus T into D delta G by DT at P. This is our equation number one. On simplify this equation, delta G minus delta H is equal to T into D delta G by DT at P. Further, we know that delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. The change in free energy is equal to the change in enthalpy minus T into change in entropy. It means that delta G minus delta H is equal to minus T delta S. This is the equation number 4. Now we can compare equation number 2 and equation number 4. We have a equation that minus T delta S is equal to T into D delta G by DT at P. Further, we know that delta G is equal to NFE. It is the relationship between Gibbs free energy and electric energy. We already explained. Firstly, then putting this value in equation number this, we have T delta S minus T delta S is equal to minus T NF DE by DT at P. Minus से minus cancel हो गया, T से T cancel हो गया. Then delta S is equal to NF into DE by DT at P. It is the required formula for the calculation of thermodynamic quantity, that is change in free energy. Now we can discuss another topic. Dear student, today we also discuss another topic of electrochemistry, and the topic is what is the concept of activity and activity coefficient. It may be noted that when an electrolyte is dissolved in water, the effective concentration of ion in a solution is different than that of actual concentration. This is because of the fact that the presence of large number of ions in a solution, the free movement of ion is hindered. Iska simple sa example kya hai ki jab hum koi maan ke chaliye koi thoda sa hi hum electrolyte kisi water matlab solution ke andar water ke andar dalte hain to automatically kya hoga, kehne ka matlab jo unki uski movement hai wo kya ho jayegi, zyada hogi. Unki movement kya hogi, free movement kya hogi, possible hogi, zyada hogi. और इसका कहने मतलब क्या है कि एक स्विमिंग पूल में एक आदमी तैर रहा है, अगर हम उसके अंदर बहुत ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सॉल्यूशन डाल देंगे वाटर के अंदर, तो ऑटोमेटिकली क्या होगा, जो फ्री मूवमेंट है वो कम हो जाएगी. क्यों? लार्ज नंबर ऑफ आयंस. इससे क्या होगा कि 10 आदमी तैर रहे हैं किसके अंदर, आपका स्विमिंग पूल के अंदर, तो ऑटोमेटिकली बोलता है जो आपकी इफेक्टिव कंसंट्रेशन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सॉल्यूशन की होती है उसी सिंपली हम क्या क्या देते हैं एक्टिविटी, द इफेक्टिव कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ आयन और द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इन ए सॉल्यूशन इज कॉल्ड एक्टिविटी एंड इट रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई ए एंड द टर्म एक्टिविटी इज रिलेटेड विद द एक्चुअल कंसंट्रेशन बाई दिस इक्वेशन ए इज इक्वल टू गामा इन टू एम वेयर गामा इज द एक्टिविटी कोएफिशिएंट एंड एम इज द मोलैलिटी. वट इज द मोलैलिटी? नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सॉल्यूट डिजॉल्व इन 1000 ग्राम ऑफ सॉल्वेंट एंड गामा इज द रेशियो ऑफ इफेक्टिव कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ एक्चुअल कंसंट्रेशन. इफ फॉर ए रियल सोल्यूशन गामा इज लेस देन morality, it means that activity coefficient is less than 1. For ideal solution, A is equal to activity is equal to morality, effective concentration is equal to the actual concentration. It means that gamma is equal to 1 in case of ideal solution. Okay.